This video is sponsored by Silverstone. The innovative Ice Mist all-in-one cooler allows you to stack RGB fans on the water block, which can easily direct airflow to any hotspots on the motherboard, VRMs, or DRAM. Pick up the Ice Mist AIO today and equip your PC with this unique high-performance cooler.
Hey PC World fans, Adam here with arguably the most important person at CES 2024. We got Dr. Ian Cutress of More Than More, Tech Potato, you pick. I've got a question for you that I've been holding on to from our one of our Discord members for a long time. He asked us this for the podcast, and when we answered it live on the air, I was like, this is an Ian question, so I've got to bring out my phone. I'm sorry, I'm going to bring it up. It's a friend of the show, Ivan R., asked this question. Considering tiles are the future of chips, can we retire x86 by isolating all legacy stuff on a separate parkable chip? All interesting stuff will run on tiles with new instructions like RISC-V. Or is x86 still good enough to serve us for another 45 years?
So the problem there is that when you run instructions from different ISAs, different instruction set architectures, you need a way to capture the new stuff from the old stuff. And that can be quite difficult. So,
is that something that could be easier in the future?
So, to give an example, Samsung on their smartphones, they had performance cores and efficiency cores that technically supported slightly different instruction sets.
Oh, really?
But if you ran an instruction that wasn't supported on one of the cores and left the system to do on its own, the system crashed. Right? So you have to catch the instruction and make sure it's run in the right area.
On the right one, okay.
So you could arguably, we already do catch some of those instructions. It's called DirectX.
Okay.
We capture graphics instructions that get sent to the graphics processor.
Okay.
And we issue kernels on the graphics card. But that's invoking an API to do it.
Okay.
In order for a modern system to do this, you'd have to have essentially a translation layer or an emulation layer, like a virtual machine.
Okay. Which, I mean, but we have that now.
But that would also add additional overhead.
But what if it wasn't, what if the penalty was worth it to be able to have both at the same time?
I think the best way to think about this is to think of it more as an offload engine, right? So you may still run traditional x86, but if you have a RISC-V code or a set of instructions, then you invoke the RISC-V cores. In the same way that if you have video, you go talk to the video decoder.
Yeah,
if you have graphics, you talk to the graphics processor. That being said, the benefits of doing it that way, probably not as important as, not as big as people think. Because ultimately, it's just it's the same thing. You could do the same with the ARM instruction set, right? But the thing is, ARM, x86, and RISC-V all do the same thing. It's a CPU.
True.
So it's that a lot of the engineers and architects like to argue that instruction set doesn't really matter. Because most programs use like 6 different operation codes in a CPU.
Okay.
And all you're doing is fighting over the little tiny differences. I've spoken to Jim Keller about this, and Jim Keller, he helped build Ryzen, he's been at Intel.
Yeah, yeah.
He did the Tesla self-driving, Apple chips. Yeah, and he arguably says ISA doesn't matter, instruction set doesn't matter. That being said, his new company, their products are going towards RISC-V, so. That could just be because it's more open and more accessible for a startup.
Of course you invoked RISC-V, more than 3 times and the boogeyman comes out the door. Yeah. No.
is that Gordon?
Yeah, right. Okay. So it sounds like something that could never happen?
It's not feasible. Nobody's looking at it. Interesting idea, but perhaps best left to research and theoreticals.
Okay, well, thank you. Thank you, Ivan. Let me bring up the question again. He does have a little side note.
Yeah.
Idea, if you really need to support 20-year-old ATM code, you can buy a CPU with a special legacy tile, and the rest of the world can enjoy efficiency, probably because of speed of modern instruction sets.
I'd say no, because of a thing called emulation.
Oh.
We already emulate consoles from 10 years ago on modern hardware. That's just an emulation layer.
Yeah.
It's arguably you could run x86 code from 20 years ago that's unsupported through an emulation layer.
And you wouldn't have that much of a performance penalty. You're able to brute force.
It wouldn't be a performance penalty because it's 20-year-old code, and you've got 20 years of more faster CPUs. I mean, it's like GameCube can easily be emulated. The GPU on a GameCube can easily be emulated by a CPU today, sort of thing. So okay. I think it's in that line.
Okay. Well, I dig it. I finally got Ian in the corner to ask him this question. Ivan, I hope you're happy. I do have a bonus question from friend of the show, Liquid R. What's your favorite way to consume potatoes that are not tech potatoes?
Probably twisty fries.
Oh, really?
Twisty fries with some seasoning.
Like the one, like a spiral, like a potato spiral kind of thing?
Helix.
Okay. That's like, I always think of that here in America as like a carnival food, you know, like you got your state fair. Where do you get it in the UK? Is it common in the UK?
Restaurants and in the frozen section, yeah.
Huh. Okay. Well, there you go. If you want to send Ian some curly, not curly fries. I love curly fries. If I had my pick, it'd be curly fries.
Or chips.
Well, okay. I was about to, like, you fumbled me for, no, I actually don't like potato chips that much. Yeah. I'm more of a French fry kind of guy.
Sure.
Anyway, that's it for this video. Obviously hard-hitting stuff happening here at CES 2024. Be sure to subscribe on PC World for more of those videos, but more importantly, go over to Tech Potato and subscribe over there for fun stuff. So thanks, Ian, for chatting.
No worries.
And thank you for watching. We'll catch you in the next video. Wait, let's see if I can do it. You do the thrust and then change your arms, right?
Yeah, there you go.
No, I am recording.
Fuck me out. No, my brain's broken.
Goes in the blooper reel.
And cut.